G'day everyone. Today we're taking a look at a homebrew game called Castle of Viana, made by MontyOnTheRun back in 2017. He made it for the CGA Game Jam that year. What makes his entry different to many of the others is that his game is actually made for MS-DOS computers and can run on a 386 or 486 machine. The basics of the game is that it's a platform game, where you, the hero, travel through the castle, the Viana di Castello, to kill the demon Capiroto. It's an extremely short game in that you can find the demon you have to kill very quickly, although learning how to kill it was a little bit of a challenge because I had some difficulty with the controls. It's a little bit difficult to describe, but basically if I pressed the jump and movement keys in the wrong order, I would end up not actually jumping and moving in the direction I wish to. I suspect that the reason this happened is because MontyOnTheRun didn't implement the controls using his own keyboard handler, he just used the BIOS routines, and that makes it much more difficult to actually read the keyboard in the manner that you need for a platform game like this. Writing your own keyboard handler isn't terribly difficult, but if you don't have the experience on how to do it, you'd have to go and look it up, and it could be quite time consuming the very first time you do it. So given the short time frame he had to develop the game, I don't really blame him for sticking with the BIOS key handler. In the end it worked out, as I was able to get used to the controls as they are, and managed to kill the demon anyway. Like I said before, this game is exceptionally short, but the main achievement here is managing to make a full MS-DOS game in an exceptionally short period of time. He's clearly managed to do this with very little assistance from any external libraries, such as Allegro, so that makes it even more impressive, as he would have had to have looked up all the technical documentation on the hardware and written something in assembler. Unfortunately, it seems he didn't have a lot of time to optimise his code, as when you try playing it on a slower 386 or 486 processor, it doesn't really play very fast. It starts to get more playable with 50MHz 486, for instance, and becomes really good at about a Pentium 75MHz from my playtesting, although that may depend on your preferences. It will also depend on which version of the game you download, as there are actually two. The first one, which he actually submitted to the CGA Game Jam, has PC speaker sound and actually performs a little bit faster than the second one. The second version has a slightly different keyboard layout, which makes it a little bit easier to control, although it still has the same issues as the first one. It also has some extra sound support in the form of the OPL3 LPT device that you can put on your parallel port. On my laptop that I tried it on, this didn't work, but I suspect it's probably a matter of the parallel port not being compatible with the game. With Castle of Viana being so short, there's not a whole lot more left for me to say. There are some technical aspects that could be improved, but I think the most glaring flaw is the lack of content, i.e. it's basically too short. That's hardly surprising given the short period of time available in the CGA Game Jam. Castle of Viana isn't the only DOS game that MontyOnTheRun has made. I'll put a link in the description below to his itch.io page, where he's got some other games he's made for MS-DOS as well. I encourage you to go there to check them out. Some of them look quite interesting. Today's video certainly was quite a short one compared to the usual. I hope you enjoyed, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.